Hello students, welcome back. Now we are going to discuss the NEET and CET MCQs regarding the chapter, the 10th chapter, that is Microbes in Human Welfare. I have uploaded all the videos regarding this chapter in my channel. You can watch the videos and you can clarify your doubts. Now we will be discussing the MCQs. So the first question, choose the correct option with regard to statement A and B. Here they have given two statements. We'll look at the statements. Statement A, microbes are present everywhere on earth. And statement B, they cannot live in thermal vents where temperature is as high as 100 degrees Celsius. See, actually microbes are present everywhere on the earth. This is correct. And even they are present in the thermal vents where temperature is as high as 100 degrees Celsius. They can able to tolerate a high temperature as high as 100 degrees Celsius. But here in the statement B, they have given they cannot live. So that only statement A is correct and B is not correct. So that option A is the correct answer. And next question. Prions are, see, you already studied about the viruses, viroids and prions. These prions are actually the proteinaceous infectious agents because they are mainly made up of proteins. That's why we will call it as a proteinaceous infectious agents, and they mainly causes diseases in plants. So prions are the proteinaceous infectious agents. And next question. Microbes, after the growth on a nutritive medium, they forms colonies. Usually when we need to culture the microbes in our laboratory, so we will be growing in the microbes in the petri plate. So there we can observe the growth of the microbes like colonies. So usually microbes after growth on a nutritive medium. In order to grow the microbes, we definitely require nutritive medium. So on that nutritive media, these microbes will form colonies. And next question, dash is are responsible for converting milk into curd. So you're all familiar with this microbe that will convert the milk into curd, that is lactobacillus and other microbes. So we have some other microbes like lactic acid bacteria. So we cannot say that only lactobacillus. Here lactobacillus and lactic acid bacteria are responsible for converting milk into curd. So that we are going for option B, lactobacillus and other microbes such as lactic acid bacteria. And next question, choose the correct option with regard to statement A and B. So here also they have given two statements. Statement A, lactic acid bacteria lab are responsible for converting milk into curd. And statement B, lab creates acidic medium necessary to coagulate and fully digest the milk proteins. So here statement A is correct. The lactic acid bacteria, they're usually responsible for converting milk into curd. And these lactic acid bacteria, they usually creates acidic medium necessary to coagulate, and they cannot fully digest the milk protein. You know that the milk protein is called as a casein. Here these lactic acid bacteria, they will partially digest the milk protein but not fully digesting. So that statement A is correct and B is incorrect. And next one, if someone wants to make a curd from milk, a small amount of curd is added to fresh milk. The small amount of curd containing millions of lactic acid bacteria is known as a inoculum. You know that whenever we want to prepare a curd, we usually add a small amount of curd or starter. The small amount of curd is called as a starter. So that starter we will be adding into the milk. And that starter usually contains millions of lactic acid bacteria. That starter or small amount of curd is known as inoculum. And next one, to prevent curd from getting sore, which parameter should be essentially controlled? So in order to prevent the curd from getting sore, so at that time, what are the parameters we need to be checked, which are essential to control that one? So here, temperature of the surrounding medium is very, very important. So if we maintain the proper temperature, it will be possible to prevent the curd from getting the sore. So that option C, that is temperature of the surrounding. Next one, which vitamin is synthesized by lactic acid bacteria? So which vitamin is synthesized by lactic acid bacteria? It is vitamin B12. So we know that curd is very, very proteinaceous because as they contain several proteins and vitamins, even they contain vitamin B12. That's why as lactic acid bacteria which are present in the curd, they usually contain vitamin B12. And next one, the puffed off dough of dosa and idli is due to, you know that during dosa and idli preparation, the dough will be used, that dough will be puffed up. So when we grind the rice and black gram, when we keep that dough for about one night or up to 10 to 12 hours, it will be puffed off. So what will be the reason for the puffed off nature of the dough? So that is mainly because of the fermentation by bacteria and production of carbon dioxide. So as the fermentation will be taking place with the help of bacteria and even yeast, and they will produce enormous amount of carbon dioxide. So as because of the production of carbon dioxide by the bacteria and yeast, it will be puffed up. So next question. Which microbe helps us in the preparation of bread? You know that in the bakeries, they commonly use the baker's yeast known as Saccharomyces cerevisiae. So here, the main microbe used for the preparation of bread is known as yeast, and its scientific name is Saccharomyces cerevisiae. So yeast is the common microbe used in bakeries or in the preparation of bread, cake, etc. Next one, baker's yeast is. So already I told you, the baker's yeast is also known as Saccharomyces cerevisiae. The spellings are very, very important. So baker's yeast, its scientific name is Saccharomyces cerevisiae. And next one, dash is the traditional drink of South India. So you know that toddy. So toddy, it is one of the traditional drink which will be used in South India, and it is usually obtained from the sap of palm trees. So toddy, it is one of the oldest traditional drink of South India. Next one, the traditional drink of South India is made by fermenting the sap from palm trees. Already I told you, so from the palm trees they will collect the sap, and that sap will be undergoing fermentation to form the traditional drink known as toddy. And next one, so next questions are related to the diagrams. So you look at the diagram A, B and C. So here the question is, the bacteria shown in figure A and B are at which level of magnification? So actually the microbes are best visible under the electron microscope. So here what the diagram you can observe A and B, they are actually the microbes which are magnified at 1500x. Students, you know that you are using in your laboratory 10x, 45x and 100x. But here, these diagrams A and B, they are magnified at 1500x. So x, it represents they are such level of magnification. So if we say 10x, it is greater or it is larger than that of the 10 times. So it will be 10 times larger than that of the original one. When we say 45x, it will be bigger or larger, 45 times larger than that of the original one. Likewise, next one, the rod shaped bacteria showing flagella is magnified at. So what the image you can see in the diagram C, so it is the rod shaped bacteria having several flagella. So this one will be magnified at 5 × 10⁴. The magnification power is about 5 × 10⁴. And next question, Swiss cheese bears large holes due to the production of carbon dioxide by which microbe? You are all familiar with the Swiss cheese because the Swiss cheese is characterized by the presence of large holes. So what will be the reason for large holes? Because of the production of large amount of carbon dioxide by a bacteria known as Propionibacterium sharmani. So Propionibacterium sharmani, it is the specific microbe which forms large holes in Swiss cheese by producing large amount of carbon dioxide. Next one, just as Swiss cheese it to bacteria, Roquefort is to, Roquefort cheese is to. So we say that a bacteria that is a Propionibacterium sharmani, it is responsible for the formation of Swiss cheese. Similarly, there is one more type of cheese known as Roquefort cheese, and this Roquefort cheese we can obtain from the fungi, that is Penicillium Roquefortii. So there is a fungi known as Penicillium roffi forti. So with the help of Penicillium roffi forti, we can obtain a special type of cheese known as Roquefort cheese. Next one, a Roquefort cheese is ripened by growing a specific fungus and on it which grows, which gives a particular flavor. So actually we will see that the cheeses are characterized by different flavor, different texture and different color. Here Roquefort cheese, it is ripened by growing a specific fungi, that is Penicillium roqueforti. So by using that microbe, it produces a specific flavor to Roquefort cheese. And next question, vessels for growing microbes on industrial scale are known as, they are the fermenters, the large vessels which are used for growing microbes in industrial scale. So whenever we want to produce a product in industrial scale, at that time we need to grow microbes in a large quantity. So in order to grow them in large quantity, we definitely need large vessels. So such large vessels which are used in industrial scale are known as fermenters. Next one, alcoholic beverages are produced by microbial fermentation of. So how we can produce alcoholic beverages? They are fermented by malted cereals, fruit juices, vegetable juices, both A and B. Here we are not using vegetable juices for alcoholic drinks or alcoholic beverages. Only malted cereals and fruit juices are mainly responsible for the alcoholic beverages. So that we can go for D, that is both A and B. Next one, Brewer's yeast is. So Brewer's yeast is again Saccharomyces cerevisiae. So Saccharomyces cerevisiae can also be called as baker's yeast, as it is used in bakeries. And why it is called as a Brewer's yeast? Because it is commonly used in Brewer's industry, that is alcoholic industry. So as they are used in Brewer's industry, it is also called as a Brewer's yeast. Again, the scientific name is Saccharomyces cerevisiae. Next one, dash is the alcoholic beverage obtained without distillation. So here, wine. There are only two alcoholic beverages which are called as undistilled alcoholic beverages. One is wine, other one is beer. The beer and wine are called as undistilled alcoholic beverages as they are not taken for the distillation process. But remaining all alcoholic beverages are said to be the distilled alcoholic beverages as they are taken for distillation process. So here among the options, wine is the one which is the alcoholic beverages obtained without distillation. Next one, point out the odd one out. So here they have given several alcoholic drinks, rum, beer, whiskey and brandy. So here we can find out the odd one will be the beer. And remaining, why I am saying that it is beer, because among all these alcoholic drinks, this is the undistilled alcoholic one, alcoholic beverages. And remaining all these three, rum, whiskey and brandy, they are the distilled alcoholic beverages. Already I told you, only two undistilled beverages, wine and beer. So here among the options, beer is the odd one because it is undistilled alcoholic beverage. Next one, antibiotics literally means. So what does the word antibiotics refers to? It is anti refers to agonist, bio means life. So that antibiotics literally means against the life. And we say that against the life of disease causing microorganisms. Next one, penicillin. Penicillin was discovered by. So who discovered penicillin is known as Alexander Fleming. So that penicillium was discovered by Alexander Fleming. Next one, penicillin was discovered by chance as the organism producing it retard the growth of dash. So actually Alexander Fleming used to work with a bacteria called as a staphylococcal bacteria, but by chance one day he observed the growth of a mold growing in the plates are in the petri plates of the staphylococci bacteria. At that time, this penicillin, it is released from the fungus or mold known as Penicillium notatum. So this penicillin, it will be retarding the growth of a bacteria known as Staphylococci bacteria. Because initially Alexander Fleming growing this Staphylococci bacteria, but in that petri plate only a mold growing, that mold releases penicillin, and this penicillin retards the growth of Staphylococci bacteria. Next one. The name penicillin was given after the mold. The mold name is Penicillium notatum. So after this Penicillium notatum only, the penicillin, it has been named. The penicillin, it is one of the best antibiotic that is obtained from the Penicillium notatum. Next one. The full potential as an effective antibiotic in the context of penicillin was studied by. So actually, the discovery of penicillin was done by Alexander Fleming. Later, it has been commercially established by two important scientists named as Ernest Chain and Howard Florey. So they have been commercially established, and the full potential as an effective antibiotic, it was studied by Ernest Chain and Howard Florey. Next one, penicillin was extensively used during which World War? Which war? So actually, penicillin, it is one of the effective antibiotic which is extensively used at the time of Second World War. So in order to treat the American wounded soldiers in the Second World War, the penicillin, it is used as an extensively, it is extensively used as an effective antibiotic, so that it is World War II. And next one, Dash soldiers were extensively treated with the penicillin during Second World War. Already I told you, American soldiers who were wounded in the Second World War, they were extensively treated with the drug penicillin. And next one, Galgoto. It is a common name for which disease? Galgoto, it is a common name for diphtheria. So we already discussed about these diseases. These are the deadliest diseases which were seen before. So here, Galgoto, it is a common name for diphtheria. And next one, Kustrog. It is a common name for which disease? It is for the leprosy. Kustrog, it is the common name for the disease known as leprosy. And next one, citric acid is produced by. So this citric acid can be obtained industrially, or we can say that so this citric acid is produced by a fungi known as Aspergillus niger. So this is one fungus, Aspergillus niger, which produces citric acid. And next one, Acetobacter acetae essentially produces, the name only indicates, it produces an acid called as acetic acid. Acetobacter acetae, it produces the acetic acid. Next one, which microbe produces butyric acid? It is a Clostridium butylicum. The name of the microbe which produces butyric acid is known as Clostridium butylicum. And next one, so they have given two images, A and B. So we'll see the questions. What is depicted in the figure A? So what you can see in the figure A, these are actually the bacterial colonies. The bacteria which usually form colonies in the petri plate, so that we can clearly observe in the diagram or in the image A. And next question, what is depicted in figure B? So this is actually the fungal colony. The fungal colonies will be very close, and they will be appearing like a thread-like structures. The thread-like structures are known as hyphae, mycelium, everything you have studied. So in the A image, they are showing the bacterial colonies, and in the B image, they are showing actually the fungal colonies. Next one, 38th question, a bacterium which is a rich source of lactic acid is. So which bacteria having a rich source of lactic acid, the name only indicates it is Lactobacillus. So Lactobacillus is the bacterium which is actually the rich source of lactic acid. And next one, which enzyme produced by microbes is an important ingredient in detergent formulation? I told you, during the preparation of detergents, they usually use an enzyme known as lipase. So this lipase enzyme, it is mainly used in the detergents. So why they are using the lipase enzyme in detergents means to remove the oily stains. So to remove the oily stains, they use an enzyme known as lipase. Next one, the fruit juices available commercially commercially are clearer than ones which are homemade. Which ingredient is added in commercially available fruit juices? So this I told you clearly in the class only. So the fruit juices which are available commercially, which means the bottled fruit juices are very clearer than that of the one which we prepare at home. So what is the reason why the bottled fruit juices are very clearer? Means such bottled fruit juices are mainly treated with the enzymes known as pectinases and proteases. The pectinases and proteases, they will be helps in clarifying the fruit juice. That's why the bottled fruit juices, as they are treated with the pectinases and proteases, they appear very clear. And next one, which enzyme is known as a clot buster? So the familiar enzyme which is known as clot buster is streptokinase. So streptokinase is the enzyme which is commonly called as a clot buster. Next one, clot buster is produced by which microbe? So already I told you clot buster, it is known as streptokinase. So this streptokinase enzyme is produced by which microbe? It is streptococcus. Streptococcus is the microbe which produces a clot buster or the enzyme known as streptokinase. Next one, the enzyme streptokinase is used medicinally too. So why we are using that streptokinase enzyme means to remove the blood clots from the blood vessels. See, when there is a internal clots or the blood clots within the vessels, such blood clots can be treated by an enzyme known as streptokinase that is obtained from the streptococcus species. Next one, which drugs are often administered before and after organ transplant procedure? So which drugs which are often administered before and after transplant procedure, they are known as immunosuppressants. Because whenever during organ transplantation, at that time the immune system will be activated and that will be rejecting the other organ which will be transplanted. So in order to prevent the rejection reaction, they use immunosuppressants. And next one, which drug is generally administered at the time of organ transplant procedure? So the main, the important immunosuppressant or immunosuppressive agent is known as cyclosporine A. Cyclosporine A, it is best known as immunosuppressive agent which is commonly used during organ transplantation. Next one, cyclosporine A is produced by a fungus known as, so cyclosporine A is produced by a fungus known as a Trichoderma polysporum. Trichoderma polysporum, it produces a immunosuppressive agent known as cyclosporine A. Next one, the blood cholesterol lowering agents are known as statins. So statins are the one which are known as blood cholesterol lowering agents and which are usually obtained from Monascus purpureus. Option B. Next one, Monascus purpureus is a commercial source of statin. Already I told you, statins, they are the blood cholesterol lowering agents obtained from the Monascus purpureus. Next one, the mechanism of action of statins is. So what is the mechanism of action of statins? So it is actually the competitive inhibition of enzyme is responsible for the synthesis of cholesterol. The main function of statin is one, that is a blood cholesterol lowering agent. At that time, it will undergo competitive inhibition of the enzymes which are responsible for the synthesis of cholesterol. So by inhibiting the enzyme responsible for synthesis of cholesterol, they can decrease the blood cholesterol. Next one, the major portion of wastewater in cities and towns is human excreta. You know that when we talk about the sewage water, the major portion of the waste water in cities and towns is mainly the human excreta. Other than human excreta, animal excreta, industrial waste, agricultural waste, etc. But among that, the human excreta is the major one. Next, questions remaining, questions related to microbes in sewage treatment. See 51 question. Municipal wastewater is also known as sewage. What the municipal wastewater which is liberated every day in large quantity, it is also known as sewage. And next one, sewage is treated in. So the sewage water can be treated only at STP. It indicates sewage treatment plants. The sewage water can be treated at sewage treatment plants. And next question, STP stands for, that is a sewage treatment plant. And next one, which microbes helps in sewage treatment? They are the heterotrophic bacteria. It may be bacteria or fungi, but the microbes are usually heterotrophic. You know what is autotrophic and what is heterotrophic. If they can able to prepare their own food, they are called as autotrophic. If they are dependent on other organisms, they are called as heterotrophic. So here, the main microbes involved in sewage treatment are known as heterotrophic microorganisms. Next one, the sewage water. The sewage water treatment is done in how many stages? So there are two steps. The sewage treatment can be done in two steps. The two steps are usually the primary treatment and the secondary treatment, or we can say that the physical treatment and the biological treatment. Next one, primary treatment of sewage waste involves which processes? So during primary treatment, there are two steps known as filtration followed by sedimentation. So there are two steps involved in primary treatment. So among primary treatment, the first one is said to be the filtration, and after filtration, there is one more step called as sedimentation. Next one, in sewage treatment plant, primary treatment involving removal of floating debris is done by, it is sequential filtration. So how we can remove the floating debris during primary treatment means by sequential filtration. So when the sewage water passed on the different size measures, so during sequential filtration, it is possible to remove all the floating debris. Next one, in primary treatment of sewage water, removal of grit involves which processes? So the grit formation, I told you the small pebbles, the small soil and small pebbles which will be settled at the bottom of the tank, so that that is known as grit, and grit will be settled in the process called as sedimentation. So sedimentation, it is the second step in primary treatment. There will be formation of grit particles. Next one, in primary treatment of sewage water, after sedimentation, the solids that settle form the primary sludge. I told you, in the primary treatment, during sedimentation or after sedimentation, the solids such as the grit particles or soil, small pebbles, all will settle at the bottom of the tank to form primary sludge. Primary sludge is the end product of primary treatment. So the primary sludge mainly contains the pebbles, soil particles, etc. Next one, the supernatant left after sedimentation of sewage water during primary treatment is known as primary effluent. So here they have just mentioned effluent. See, actually during filtration, all the floating debris will be removed. When it is passed on to sedimentation tank, so all the soil, grit particles, everything will be settled at the bottom of the tank. So these particles are known as a primary sludge, and remaining the supernatant which will be floating above is known as a primary effluent. That is known as primary effluent. So remaining questions we can discuss in the next class. Thank you.